the new one, Village. Tell me about Village.
Village.
Go on, Brad. You go, mate.
All right. Well, let's find out where we're up to then. Because I've put in about 8 or 9 hours in as well. I think like a day.
I've just got like, I'll tell you who I am. This might give you. I've just got like a little jar, little orange jar.
Oh, yeah. So you're pretty much at exactly the same point as me then.
I know what's in the jar.
Oh, I don't. I didn't even look at it yet.
Is it Haribo's?
It's definitely not Haribo's. It's a sad jar. But yeah, that's where I'm. I'm a little bit further than Brad then. Just a little tad further than you then.
Right. Yeah. So you're back outside.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right. We established that.
Yeah.
Right. So it's another game.
Go on, Brad. You go.
All right. Yeah. So really enjoying it so far. It's brilliant. The atmosphere is incredible. I love the locations. You obviously. This will be spoiler free. We'll tiptoe around some points, but yeah, you start outside in a village which is really fucked up and all messed up, and you know, eventually you make your way to the castle. So you've got the different locations which are just so on point. Like in a horror film, you'd cherry pick these locations. I think like an abandoned village, a dungeon, and a castle. Like, you know, you just got these, and they're so atmospheric, and you know, they're absolutely on point, the location. So kudos for nailing that part of the game. The visuals are just stunning. The music, the atmosphere is brilliant. The story is, it's all right, I guess. You know what my one gripe is? The story's all right. Like, you've got your motivation. I guess it's not really spoiling to talk about because it's the opening scene, but you're kind of trying to retrieve your baby who was snatched from you at the start from what you're assuming is the bloody vampires at the castle.
Bloody bastards.
So there's the motivation there, but the story throughout the game isn't really, it's like, it's whatever, it's much of a muchness, but I guess that doesn't matter.
They kind of like set the plot device up, this is what you need to do, and then but the game is just...
This is your motivation, getting there.
Remember that.
I thought that, and where I am now, just that little bit further, it's kind of like he's kind of in a haze. He's like, none of this makes any sense, but I have to get my baby back. Like, even makes even less sense where I am, because you find something out. It's like, this is fucking weird, and I hate this, but I've got to get my baby back. So that's what he's doing. Like, when you get to where I am, you're like,
okay,
I guess if I was in this situation, I'd just carry on going. I've got to get it. It's my baby. I've got to get it back, innit?
How scary are you finding it?
So at the beginning of the game, it's fucking mental, because they're like, you're like, this is mad. This is like not necessarily, I'd say it is scary, but it's also like, I have no guns, I have no bullets. These things don't die when I do have bullets and guns. So I don't even think I'd be helped. I don't even think it'd be helpful if I had loads of bullets and guns. These things just don't want to die. That's why I run past them. Oh, no, they're really fast. They've caught me anyway. So let's set up the game brilliantly. And I've got to a point now where I'm like, because in all Resident Evil, because you seem to get to a point where you've got enough guns and enough ammo and you've got good at it. You're like, ah, fuck it. These things, they ain't too much to me. But then you find that there's 6 of them and you kill all them. And you're like, bullets are all gone. I'm back in the terrifying situation. I've only got to get caught by them like 3 times and then I'm dead.
Yeah.
So they're doing that because I'm playing it on normal difficult at the moment, and they're doing that really well when it comes to managing your ammo and thinking, I'm going to try and take that out from a distance, hopefully get a headshot, because I know if that comes towards me now, I've got like 26 bullets and I can kill it with 6. Less if I get headshots. So it does make you think. But yeah, the beginning of it, man, like those things running at you. And when you go into when you go into dungeons and that, and you're like, you just hear them. You hear them like walking around. You're like, right, where are they? Because there's so many in a dungeon. It obviously works like a dungeon. So there's loads of different pathways and they're all black and they're all dark. And these things can come out of any of them. So you're just looking, you're like, where the fuck is that thing coming from? The atmosphere and the gameplay, the mechanics, they're a little bit different from other Resident Evils. Like, you still seem to have like a compartment where you put your guns and that. And one thing they don't tell you, or if they did, I wasn't listening, you can organize that. So you'll go to pick something up and they're like, you've got no room in your inventory. You're like, oh, shit. But you don't, if you move it about and you do it cleverly and do it smart, you can fit more stuff in. You can buy upgrades as well, like the old games. But key items just seem to be in a list of their own. So it used to be, oh, I've picked up a crank. I've used all the cranks around it and it had come up with like a little red bin and then you just like dispose of it. You're like, I don't need that crank anymore.
I know that now.
Yeah, he knows
that. I get that reference. Now. Yeah.
But now it seems to be...
I haven't had my inventory full once yet.
Yeah, this is the thing. So I did, when I picked up another gun, because it took up like six slots and I've just been dumping stuff in my inventory. I had like a plant there which I had to move over and then I could pick up the gun.
Right.
I think if you upgrade, because I didn't get the infantry upgrades to way later on. I just like, I'm not buying them. I've got loads of room. And then I picked up so many guns and I was like, oh, shit. But yeah, when you pick up cranks and key items, they go into a separate category. And all of like your treasure that you pick up that you sell, they go into a separate category. So the only one in you have to take inventory of is like health, bullets, your actual guns, and stuff like that. All the scrap goes into another category. Consumables, all that is you have to manage. All the treasure you get, you don't, that goes into another category. All the like usable items, like say like a crank, or you've got like, what else do you actually use, like keys, they all go into another category. You don't have to worry about them. You ain't got to worry about, oh, I've got a diamond key and it's taken up two slots and I need to pick up this ammo. You ain't got to worry about that. Which is quite nice, different for Resident Evil though, because you don't actually have a safe deposit box. You don't have one. It seems to be like if you've got a handgun and you get a better one, maybe you do, just sell the old one.
Inventory issues in games are so frustrating. They're such like a pain point. It's like, oh, really?
You're going to love Mass Effect 1. Yeah, if they've not changed it, you're going to be really enjoyable for it.
It just feels like such an unnecessary evil. It's like, why? Yeah. But I agree with you. The start of the game is like fucking my heart was pounding the whole time.
Yeah.
And then it turns into a different kind of horror. Because to be fair, I'm not a massive Resident Evil fan. I'm a horror game fan. And I really liked Biohazard. I thought it was brilliant horror game. And I was a bit... I'd read a couple of previews on Village and some people said, oh, it's not as much as a horror game. It's more of a Resident Evil game. It's more action. And it starts off like that, but then it's not at all. Like the whole, the last few hours I've been playing, it's like fucking horror. Like walking around that castle, it's creepy as fuck. And there's all the puzzles, it's all the same stuff. So I didn't really agree with that take. It's a really, really good horror game, but it still is Resident Evil at its core. It's brilliant. It's brilliant.
I've got a question to ask you. You know the ones with the flaming bells? You had to find them. Did you cheat? Yeah.
No.
You found them? No. Good. I didn't, and it took me about a half hour.
What was the last one you found? The one out
on the bloody chandelier?
No,
the one outside. I found that straight away. The one in the chandelier, you had to be a certain point on the steps to see the bloody thing.
Yeah. No, I went up to the top of the steps and was looking around. I was like, oh, there it is.
Yeah.
I did cheat on another point, though. I can't remember what, but...
Oh, I haven't cheated once yet. I probably just missed that bit then. But there's points in the game where I've discovered once, unless you can get back to the point where I've missed it, because I can't go into too much details, I think there is points you can miss. So really take, if you're playing it, really take advantage of where you are at the moment. Make sure you've done everything before you carry on. You think it's going to change the plot, because I'm pretty sure there was a crypt I could have gone in and I didn't go into it.
I've heard that there's like, not so side quests, but there's like side paths that you can go down, by exploring that's the way you're going to only find certain weapons if you take the time to explore.
It was and like on
the more village you unlock, the more you can have a look around. Because I haven't played it, but I've watched some reviews.
It was like on Biohazard. They don't hold your hand. They don't tell you everything. It's like there was a shotgun you could get. So the first shotgun you get in Biohazard, you have to take it off of a statue. And as soon as you take it off the statue, big gate comes up and you're like, oh, shit. Right, okay, I need to replace it. You find a broken shotgun. You're like, oh, I'll put the broken shotgun. Right, now I've got the working shotgun. I'll carry on with the rest of the game and be happy. But it turns out you also find a toy shotgun. So you can use the toy shotgun, take the broken shotgun back off, go find some repair parts and repair the broken shotgun. It's better than the original shotgun. They don't tell you any of this. You just got to figure that out for yourself.
Yeah.
So I'd imagine there's going to be a lot more. And people love that. So I imagine there's going to be a lot more of that in this game. But I don't know where they are because I haven't played it enough, but yeah, no, I'm really enjoying the game. And I don't know if you're a bit worried, Brad, about it being short. The part I've got to it, because yeah. I thought, oh, okay, well, I'm just gonna go grab me. I'll go grab me baby now. Yeah. But this it's opened up massively, and okay. I was like, oh fucking hell, I've got a long time to go before this is over. Then, which okay. is brilliant. Which is.
Yeah, maybe I was thinking, after what happened, I was we wrap it up now.
Yeah, but no, you're not. And yeah, you get a little statue of like Demetrisco, the woman. Yeah. If you turn that statue around, that's got a caboose on it, mate. I'll tell you now. I was like, I love that. Because I don't know if they knew this from when they made the game that everyone was going to be obsessed with her, or they've quickly added it in. But that's got so much dialogue to do with her body. Right. Even once you sell that statue to the Duke, he makes a comment on it and you're like,
really?
Man, they're horn dogs. They really are horn dogs.
I thought they started it, didn't they? I thought you said they started it, Capcom, about the whole...
Well, yeah, they make it very obvious, like the angles and that. But I don't know if they knew people was going to pick up it. Maybe they know that gamers, these gamers who play these games, just little honking dogs. Maybe they knew that. But yeah, it did make me laugh. I was like, so clever.
I was going to say, why don't we talk about what everyone's here for, Lady Demetrisco?
She worked really well. She was brilliant.
As like an enemy, she's kind of like a nemesis, Mr. X type.
At a certain point in the game, she walks around the castle, and if you see her, like Mr. X was scary because he would punch her. If you see her, I don't know what sort. I didn't get caught from her again, but I had full health. I got one hit from her and I was fucking seeing red. I could barely run. And there's points in the game where it's just a normal mechanic. So you're like lifting something up, or you're pulling the switch. And this is what I love. They do this so well. The game developers do this so well. It's just like, right, okay, yeah, right, okay. You're even won't even pay attention. You're like, oh, I just pull that switch and you're looking at something else. You look over and you're like, what the fuck just happened? Because they've put a little cutscene in and something you've done hundreds of times. And then it's like, oh, shit. And I tell you what, Ethan's a trooper. The amount he goes through. God loves a trier, but that poor bastard has been through some shit and he's still carrying on. He's gonna have that PTSD through the fucking roof, mate. I'll tell you now. Because
absolutely. Talking about Ethan, do you need to play 7 ideally? Would it add to the story? Obviously, because it's a sequel.
I think it would, but to be honest, you could just look up a video of about 5 minutes.
Sure.
Probably. I mean, they do give you a recap at the beginning of the game. They give you a recap and that tells you everything you need to know. If you want to get into a bit more detail, watch a 5 to 15 minute video.
Yeah.
I would always say play 7 because it was brilliant.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
I mean,
sure.
If you just into
I don't feel like you'd miss out on anything by just jumping into Village. I don't feel like there's no point where you'd be confused about, I needed to know that in the last film to know that it's the same character, but they are technically separate. And like Ash said, there is a recap anyway. You won't miss out on.
And that's a good recap at the beginning.
Sorry. Yeah.
Told you everything you need to know. Didn't cut out all of the stuff in the middle. Just gave you like, look, this is him. Bosh, this happened.
I'll tell you what. I think at the moment, I prefer Biohazard.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you why. Tell me why. Not location wise, I think this Village is better, but in terms of the protagonists, I think vampires don't scare me. Like she's a brilliant character, right?
Fucking lichens, dude.
She is good, and it's creepy as fuck when she's walking around that castle, and you're like, you can hear it, and the music changing. You're like, oh my god, I've got to fucking hide from this bitch.
Yeah.
Like that is terrifying. Don't get me wrong, but in general, vampires are sisters. Like they come at you. Yeah. There was something about that last one, Biohazard, being in a house full of fucking nutters. People off their trolley just run around with shovels. That was a different level of
scare. and I think again it falls into the thing that was new. It was like, oh, this is scary. This is like playing Texas Chainsaw Massacre, but I'm the actual person now. I've got to run around this scary house. Sure. So I think it's always going to be hard to carry on from it. But I think the enemies in this one are a lot better because the old ones you just had like slugmen. Black slugmen, didn't you?
Yeah.
That was a bit of a pain. But this has got so many diverse with the enemies. Yeah. And those lichens do scare the shit out of me. Go on.
Sorry, lichens. They're vampires?
They're the werewolves.
They're the werewolves. Okay.
So the way it seems to be working for me anyway is lichens seem to be outside. They're controlled by the guy you see with the hammer. in a hat. He's I won't go into it too much, but he seems to control them to an extent, and Mother Miranda definitely controls everyone, so she does as well.
Okay.
Again, I can't go into it too much. I will when we can.
Yeah.
But yeah, werewolves seem to be outside, inside castle, vampires. That's all you need to know.
Yeah. Do you Horrible think choice. It's a good step adding that more diverse of enemies? So away from zombies and in adding more mythological, mythological.
Yeah, they're definitely going to bring it all together and be like, right, this is why these people are like this. And they always do. They'd never leave it just open-ended, just like, oh, sometimes this happens.
So they're explaining it. Will it tie into, like, Umbrella Corp and, like, the T-virus and the G-virus and what's called the Lycans and the vampires? And
100%, I reckon it will, because they never leave it open. They even explained in Biohazard why they was, like, weird black slug men. It's because of a mold, which they, in the other things they experimented on, and it just turned people into zombies. This was like a pure form, and this is why it made everyone go mental.
Apparently there is little nods and Easter eggs if you have played all the other games. Is that true? Have you seen any nods back to, like, not just Biohazard, but like to the earlier ones?
I haven't, but maybe I haven't been paying enough attention.
Mm. Sure, I don't know what they were personally.
No, I mean, I definitely notice it's still the acting, and it's still a bit funny sometimes, but I think that's just the way it is, because you're like, whoa, that was really dangerous. And it's like, mate, you just got like your limbs bitten off. Like, you should be a bit more.
Whoa, that was a close one.
Whoa, I need to take a breath. Legs. And it's like,
gluing his arm back on. Yeah, Jesus. You're like, Jesus.
Whoa, I need to be more careful. And it's like, you do. That is true. A bit of an understatement if I'd say anything.
It's me for a lot. There's nothing.
Yeah, but yeah, the game opens up massively, and there's a lot more bosses than you think there's going to be.
Sure.
Maybe with a certain boss, I wish they would have stayed around a bit longer, but that's all I'm going to say on that.
And who's worse? Is it Lady Dimitrescu or her daughters? Who are more?
To be honest, not going to lie to you, the daughters ain't that bad. Like, once you realise what you've got to do, you can take them out nice and easy. But again, I think that adds...
They're quite fit as well.
Yeah, they are, which is nice. You don't mind you biting me, love. We...
Come by me.
At first, you're like, when you first start beating, you're like, oh, fucking hell, this is a... Maybe I should have put it on a harder difficulty, because I think I'm going to blow through this. And then, like I say, when you get to IM, you're like, oh, no. If they'd have made them super hard, I'd be playing this fucking game forever. So sure, I can understand why. But yeah, it makes sense why they're so easy, because of what you have to do to get rid of them.
Sure.
Again, it's just, I'm really enjoying it.
To backtrack slightly, to Brad Moore's, what you were saying about it's not scary. Is that because you played it in VR? Do you reckon because you played 7 in VR, is that taken away from this game a little bit because you're not?
I think that does play a big part of it, and that's what I'm very conscious of. I don't think if I was to play this game in VR, fucking hell, I don't know if I could.
You'd have a heart attack.
Yeah, maybe that's why they didn't do it, for health reasons. especially the outside bit, the werewolves, especially that bit, like inside the mansion would be the same sort of experience. Is you've got Dimitrescu walking around, and like, you know, she's just started chasing, that feeling is horrible in VR. Like, to actually look behind you and see her walking down and getting her claws out, that would be
I think I'd stop.
That would be awful. but similar to what was in Biohazard.
There he is.
Similar to Biohazard. But yeah, with the action parts outside, I think it might be a bit too much for VR, a bit too fast.
Yeah, sure. 100%.
And wouldn't work as well, which I think is why. But the VR did bring so much to it. It honestly took horror to horror games on VR to a new level with Biohazard. But
I can totally understand why. Brett, you just going to ask a question?
I was just going to say, it's pretty self-explanatory, you'd both recommend this. You think it's a good
100%. 100%. If you're into horror games and you're into Resident Evil games, it's a win-win either way. If you're just into horror games and you're just into Resident Evil games, it's still going to work.
But
if you're a horror fan and you just want to jump into something, and for some reason you haven't played 7, jump into this. It's great.
How does it perform? Sorry to cut you off there, Brad.
How does it perform? Really well. I haven't had any lag at all. you're constantly spinning. I've played it, I've had a few times where I'm like, I've got to go, oh no, I'll go there. And then I've moved the camera around so much, I'm like, whoa, bloody hell, that was too quick. I'm playing on PlayStation 5, but yeah, I've got any frame rate. I haven't seen a loading screen once. And considering I'm going from building to building to building, underground, upper ladder, all this stuff, I haven't seen the loading screen once.
Okay, that's cool. Because so, you both said how good it looked from the demo. I think you've both said how stunning it looks with the ray tracing.
Yeah, when you walk through like a low in this in the cellar, you walk through like a massive, like how can I explain it? Like there's just blood everywhere, and you're walking through it, and every time you take a step, you get ripples, and if you go in a different direction, you get ripples going in that way. So, and the way the light shines through is just brilliant. I'd definitely say, focus on the brightness balance as well, because it adds a lot to the game. It can be annoying sometimes because there's a really annoying feature on it. You seem to have a torch, but he decides when he wants to turn it on. If that was me, I'd have that on all the time. I'd have it on outside because it's well dark in that game, but it adds to it because you don't know what's around the corner.
Yeah, sure. That's the horror. Go on, Brad. Sorry.
It's just a real great game to pick up as well. Like, I hate starting a game and I don't know what the fuck I've got to do, and I've like got all these texts come up that I've got to read and all this inventory and all this stuff. I just love games that start so simply, like with such simplicity, and you just work it out as you go along. It's one of those games that you can just dive into, not have to think about it. You walk around with nothing in your hands and you pick up one item and you use that for there. And there's no, you know, there is no tutorial. It's just not needed for a game like this. And they're my sort of games, because I can't be fucking bothered. I'm too old to do tutorials and read shit nowadays in my gaming. I'm a lazy gamer. And it's one of the things I love about the newer Resident Evil games. You just jump in and just learn it as you go. And it's so easy to get stuck in, and you're immediately, you're not having to think about mechanics. It's just such a smooth transition. You're just in the game from the start, and you know there's nothing to learn. You just know how to walk.
It's almost like optional. If that makes sense.
Yeah. If you wanted to make it a lot more complicated, you could, to an extent. You could think about chucking landmine down, which are really good. You could learn how to make them before you go into a situation. You could plan that out if you really wanted to, and it'd probably make it a completely different game. But like Brad says, you can just think, oh, I'm going to spend, instead of spending my scrap on making a landmine and sorting out a way of drawing these people in, I'm just going to make some shotgun shells. So I'm just going to fucking try and aim for their head and take them out that way.
Sure.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah, it's nice. Brilliant. Nice, easy game to get on with.
The I've got a Metacritic score at the minute for it. It's 84. So
84? Well, that is low. Yeah. It's low. Definitely didn't think it'd be that low. I know it's not the final thing, but
yeah,
I've not seen any bad reviews on it yet.
25. Someone scored it a zero. They didn't appreciate it.
They didn't buy it. They're just being
poor
idiot.
Gameplay shooter. This is not horror. Play a 10-year-old Metro 2033 and taste what a proper horror shooter is.
Is that a user or a critic?
These are under. Yeah, that's a user review.
Yeah, that don't count towards the score.
No, but yeah, I'm just saying, yeah, someone's that's
troll. Every game gets a zero.
Some person
just likes to shit on anything.
Yeah. But, me and Brad are just wrong. Maybe next week it'll come out. It's the worst game ever released. And we were I really enjoyed it.
Interesting. Like, yeah, I just pull it up because everyone's saying how good it is. So I've seen all the reviews, and then like, you say, yeah, it's obviously a troll, and it's just someone's just like, no, I'm going to put zero on Metacritic, and that's going
to... Because I like to be different. But then again,
I don't get some people.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, that's pretty much all I can say without spoiling it.
I don't enjoy Last of Us 2. I wouldn't bother going out my way.
Oh, the amount of zeros are probably on that.
I just don't care. Not for me.
There'll be zeros on Red Dead as well. You go on Red Dead. Every game will have zero. It's just silly. But cool. Glad you're both enjoying it. Obviously, expectations were higher.
Mm.
Hopefully,
they've been met. They've been met so far. They've been met. Yeah.
Met.
Yeah. Thumbs up.
Yeah. Execution.
Yeah.
Cool. Are we sticking with Resident Evil?
Yeah, I'll do.